Hey guys, welcome to Electronics Innovation. In this tutorial, we are going to see how to post data to the Amazon Web Services. In this task, we will interface DHT11 with the ESP32 and post the temperature and humidity data to the Amazon Web Services using Arduino IDE. So let's begin this tutorial. Requirements are ESP32, DHT11 or DHT22, an account in Amazon Web Services, and an Arduino IDE installed in your computer. So, a total this process includes the 5 steps. One is installing required libraries and creating. A second thing is creating a thing in AWS, generating a certificate and attaching a policy to it. And third is modification in the Arduino sketch according to the thing. And fourth is a testing and subscription of a thing on AWS. A five is uploading code to the ESP32 and live demo of data logging. So let's begin this first step, installing required libraries. So for this we have to install two libraries. One is Hornbill examples and another is DHT11. So go to the links which I have given in the description and download the following. Here we got the Hornbill examples master downloaded, and we need to download this DHT sensor library also. So clone or download, download zip, and okay, and here you will get your file downloaded. So copy these two files in the one folder and extract them. These are the libraries, and DHT sensor library, this is the library we got, and rename it as DHT and go get inside of that, and we need to delete these two files. You just delete this, we don't require them, and come back and Hornbill example master and go to the Arduino ESP32 which we are going to use for the data posting. And copy this file AWS IoT and go to the Arduino libraries. These libraries needs to be add there, so just simply paste it over here. I have already pasted it here, you can see AWS IoT. yeah, so this is the library we got, and these are the library files that have developed by the Hornbill. And we need to add the DHT also. So go to the same folder and copy this and go to the Arduino libraries and paste it over here. I have already paste. These are the library files. We have completed the first part, and let's move to the second part. The second one is creating a thing in AWS, generating a certificate and attaching a policy to it. And for that, you need to log into your AWS account. So first, go to the Google and click, just type AWS and you will get this link, and sign into the console. I already signed in, and you just type IoT, and IoT core will be displayed on the third. So you just click on that, and that will redirect to you the main page of the AWS IoT core, and AWS IoT is here, and go to the manage and register a thing, create a single thing, give a thing name, whatever you want to give you can give here. I am giving DHT11_demo. That's it, and come down. Next, and here we need to create a certificate also. I successfully created a certificate, and these three are the certificates which are used to communicate with the AWS server for the authentication. So just download these two. One is certificate for this thing and the private key. So download this also. And you also need to download the root CA for AWS IoT. So there are three keys, but we will download only one, that is Amazon Root CA1. So this is the certificate, and you just copy this and open MS Word file. Paste this certificate data in that and save as. Amazon Root CA1, and here we need to activate it and done. Click on done. Here you have successfully created one thing and certificate. Go to the policies, and here we need to create a policy also. So click on the create and give a name to your policy. So here I am giving a policy underscore DHT-W1. And action, I am mentioning a star. A star means it will allow all. So you just replace both fields as with a star and allow it. And then create a policy, and you have successfully created the policy here. We need to attach this policy to the previous certificate. So go to the certificate and click on these three dots and attach policy. Check this policy underscore DHT-W1 and attach. You have successfully attached your policy. We have also completed the second part, and let's move to third one. Modification in the Arduino sketch according to the thing. So whatever the thing you have created, we need to perform some modification to that thing. So go to the AWS IoT library in the Arduino IDE, and go to the SRC files and click on the AWS IoT certificate.c. And here we need to do some modification regarding the certificates of the your thing. So these three fields we need to update. And these three are the certificates that we got for the authentication. And open this certificate.pem.crt with the Microsoft Word, and we need to do some modifications here in this. So you just add a backslash n backslash and add that to the all lines. Copy this and go to the AWS IoT certificates, and this is the PEMCRT, replace it. And come back to here and open this private key with the MS Word Office only. Open with more options and MS Word. And do the repeat the same thing which we have done in the previous for the previous file. Copy this and open this AWS IoT. AWS IoT certificate.c and paste it over here. This is the private PEM key, right? So we need to paste it here. Just paste here. And now one thing is left, that is the Root CA certificate. And go to the same folder again and open this Amazon root CA1 DOCX and perform the same thing. And copy the certificate also. And paste it over here. And save it. Visit the following link to get this code and open the code with the Arduino IDE. And let's edit this sketch. So according to your sketch, we need to perform some modification. And in the meanwhile, I will explain the code also. So here we are including the Wi-Fi.h, DHT.h and AWS IoT.h. And a DHT pin is 33. I am going to connect my DHT11 to the 33 pin of ESP32. And DHT type is DHT11. And if you want to use DHT22, you just simply replace here DHT11 with the DHT22. That's it. And these are the Wi-Fi credentials you have to provide. And provide your Wi-Fi SSID and password here. And these three are the main things you need to take care of while you are connecting your device to the Amazon Web Services. So the first thing is a client ID. This client ID is a thing unique ID. This should be the unique among all things associated with your AWS account. And here I am named my client ID as temp_humidity. And one more thing is MQTT topic here. So we are using MQTT protocol to transfer data from our device to the AWS. So this MQTT topic we need to get from the website and go to the things. And click on that thing you have registered and go to the interact button and this update to this thing shadow. So copy this text, this is the link and this is the MQTT topic for your thing and paste it over here. That's it. And this is the AWS host. This host also you need to get from the your AWS website only. So just go to the website and you can find it in this field. So copy this and paste it over there. And here we have some object creations. And coming to the void setup, this is the 9600 baud rate for serial monitor. And here I have given some commands to know what is happening inside of the DHT22. And initializing Wi-Fi and connecting to a Wi-Fi SSID. This Wi-Fi SSID is whatever you have given above. That is, I have given electronics innovation. And this Wi-Fi dot begin will connect your thing to the Wi-Fi, and after successful connection and it will initialize the DHT11 and it will be done. After that, initializing connection to the AWS, and here AWS host and client ID. With these things we are able to initialize connection, and these are the fields to take data from the DHT. Temperature and humidity is not a number and it will show reading failed else, and it will make a string whatever that data which have taken, and this string data we are going to post to the AWS. And after getting the payload, we are just hitting MQTT topic with the payload and we are waiting for 1 second to post the data. We have completed the third part also. Let's move to the fourth part, that is testing or subscription of a thing on AWS. And go to the website again and go back. Go to this test bar, and here you need to subscribe your MQTT topic. So go to your code and copy that MQTT topic which we have placed there, and copy from there, paste over here, and subscribe to the topic. And before subscribing, you just check these fields as it is and subscribe. And we have done the fourth part also. Let's move to the final part, that is uploading code to the ESP32 and live demo of data logging. Connect the circuit as shown and connect the data pin to the IO33. And this is the ESP32 which I am going to use. And this is the DHT11 sensor that I am using here. And I am taking a minute to connect to it. Yeah, connection has been done. And connect your micro USB to the ESP32 module. And connect the another end of the data cable to your PC. And open your Arduino IDE. Follow the same instruction. Let's upload it. And first it will compile the sketch, and then it will create a hex file, and then it will upload the sketch to there. So while uploading, when you got this connecting, you need to press this boot button once. After that, the uploading will be initiated. And here it is uploading. It will take a few seconds to get it uploaded. Here we got done uploading, and now open the serial monitor. Initializing thing temp underscore humidity underscore DHT0 and initializing Wi-Fi and connected to the electronics innovation. Yeah, the connection made success, and initializing connection to the AWS, and this is also done. My current room temperature is 29 degrees Celsius and humidity is 77%, and the same data will be transferred to the server. So go to the server, Amazon Web Services, and here we are getting the data, same data. This is how we are transferring this DHT11 data to the AWS, and I think this is a little bit a lengthy process, but we need to follow. Yeah, thank you for watching.